The Plant Kingdom. Scientists who study plants are called botanists. Botanists have divided plants into four main groups: algae and fungi, mosses and liverworts, ferns, club mosses and horsetail, seed-bearing plants. This means the grouping of plants on the basis of their characteristics. So, plants are classified into four main groups. We start from algae. Algae, singular alga, usually live in water. Some algae are present in the surface layer of the water in sea and lakes. Chlorococcum is a single cell alga that lives on trees and damp place and damp walls. Chlamydomonas is a single cell alga that swim about in water. Volvix is an alga that lives in colonies and move about freely. Spirogyra is an alga that does not move at all. Seaweeds are also algae. They occur in many different shapes, size and colors. Dear student, algae are mostly green, so they can make their own food by photosynthesis. Some algae such as seaweeds live in the sea. So these are the different types of algae. Chlamydomonas, Volvix live in colonies form. Spirogyra and seaweeds. Seaweeds live in sea. Algae is a plural word and alga is a singular word. Fungi, mold, mushrooms, toadstools and puffballs are all examples of fungi, singular fungus. Fungi are plants that are not green. They do not contain the green matter chlorophyll, which other plants use to make food for sunlight. Fungi live to grow in dark, damp places. Most fungi feed off dead and rotting plants. Some fungi are parasites. This means they take their food from other living plants or animals. All fungi are made of thin threads called hypha that take in food from living or decaying things around them. Dear students, fungi are not green, so they cannot make their own food like plants. Plants make their own food because plants have chlorophyll, but fungi have no chlorophyll, so fungi cannot make their own food. They grow in dark, damp places and get their food from dead, rotting plants. They are made of thin thread called hypha, which help to absorb food. Some fungi are parasites. Parasites mean those organisms which get their food from other living things. So, and dear student, fungi cause many diseases. These two are the example of fungi, mushroom and mold. Some skin disease such as athlete's foot, scabs and ringworm are caused by fungi. So dear student, these are skin disease, ringworm and athlete's foot. Leeches. Leeches are plants that are created by fungi and algae living together. The fungi need the food that the algae provide and the algae need the fungi to protect them. Leeches are very hardy plants. They can survive the coldest weather and the harshest winds by growing close to the ground. Leeches have no leaves, stems or roots. They can grow on hard surfaces such as rocks and walls. Leeches grow very slowly and can live for the thousands of years. They usually grow in moist condition, but they can survive even in the dry heat of the desert. Most lichens are sensitive to air pollution, so the greatest variety can be found where the air is cleanest. Dear student, lichens are plants that are made up of fungus and an algae living together. The algae prepares the food and the fungus protect the algae. The structure of lichen and their habitats. Lichens grow very slowly and can live for thousands of years. They can live in very dry condition. Most lichens are sensitive to air pollution, so they are not found in places where the air is polluted. Mosses and liverworts. Mosses grow best in moist, shady places. Most mosses are only a few centimeters tall. They have thin stems covered with tiny green leaves. Tiny hairs hold the moss down on the ground. There are tiny pear-shaped capsules on thick, thin stalks above the leaves. Inside the capsule, there are spores which can grow into new moss plants. Liverwort may be leaf-like mosses or they may be flat and branched. Both forms reproduce by spore form in capsule. Dear student, look at here. Dear students, these are the structure of mosses and liverwort. Mosses produce seed and flower. They produce spore in special capsule. The spore can grow into new plants. Dear students, spores are just like small dot. Look at here. Spore are like that. And from these spore, new plant is produced. Ferns. Ferns are plants that like to grow in damp, shady places. Ferns have tiny tubes inside their stems and leaves. These tubes carry food and water from one part of the plant to another. The leaves of fern plants are called ferns. Each fern is divided into lots of leaflets. All ferns reproduce by making spores. Fern spores grow in tiny clusters on the underside of the leaflets in special pores called sporangia. Each sporangium splits open and releases the spores, which then fall to the ground. Dear student, ferns grow like other plants. Like flowering plants, ferns have tiny tubes inside their stems and leaves. These tubes carry food and water. Ferns produce flower. The spores are produced in sporangia on the leaflet of on the underside of leaflet. Seed-bearing plants. Dear students, here we discuss seed-bearing plants, which is gymnosperm and angiosperm. Gymnosperm are seed-bearing plants that are non-flowering. They have well-developed roots, stems, and leaves. They have fine, needle-like leaves. They produce seed in special structure called cones. Cycas and pinus are example of gymnosperm. Dear student, gymnosperm are seed-bearing plants that produce seed in cones. Now look at here. This is pine tree, and their leaves are needle-like. Now turn the page. Angiosperm are seed-bearing flowering plants. They have well-developed roots, stem, and leaves. They are classified into groups, monocotyledons and dicotyledons. Dear student, angiosperm have flowers and seed. They produce flower and they make seed inside fruits. They are classified into two types, monocotyledons and dicotyledons. Monocotyledons. Mono mean one. Cotyledons mean seed leaf. Mean monocotyledons have produced seed with one seed leaf. In monocotyledons plant, the floral parts are usually arranged in groups or multiples of three. Their leaves have veins running parallel to one another. Most monocotyledons plants have fibrous root system. They produce seed with one seed leaf, mean monocotyledons. Now students, look at here. This is veins and they run parallel to each other. Mono mean one and cotyledons mean seed leaf. Monocotyledons mean they produce seed with one seed leaf. Some common examples of monocotyledons plants are wheat, rice, maize and lily. Dicotyledons. In dicotyledons plants, the floral parts are usually arranged in groups of four or five. Their leaves have veins arranged in a branch network. Most dicotyledonous plants have a tape root system. They produce seed with two seed leaves. Dear student, di mean two, cotyledons mean seed leaf. Dicotyledons mean they produce seed with two seed leaf. Now look at here students, this is leaf of dicotyledons, where this is vein which have branches. Some common examples of dicotyledonous plants are hibiscus, peas, beans and castor oil plants. The animal kingdom. Animals can be classified into two main groups, vertebrates or animals with backbones and invertebrates or animals without backbones. Dear student, animals are divided into two main groups, one vertebrate and second invertebrates. Vertebrates are those which have backbone and invertebrates are those which are without backbone. Invertebrates. Scientists have already named about 1 million different types of invertebrates. Dear student, here I will tell you briefly the examples of invertebrate. First, sponges. Dear student, sponges lie. Sponges attach themselves to rocks or plants. Another example, solenodrates. And the example of solenodrates are jellyfish and pearls. They are called solenodrates because they have hollow bodies. They have thick arms called tentacles with which they swim about and catch food. They live in water and eat tiny plants and animals. Another, worms. Dear students, some worms live inside our bodies. They are parasites. Parasite means those organisms which live in the body of an other living organism. Dear student, leech is also a parasite. It sucks blood of animals. Vertebrates. Vertebrates can be classified into different groups. Dear student, vertebrates are divided into different groups on the base of their backbone. Vertebrates are divided into five different groups. First, fish, amphibian, reptiles, birds, and mammals. Here, the characteristics of all these groups are mentioned. But I will tell you in short. First, fish. Dear student, fish have fins and scales. They live in water and breathe through gills. Second group, amphibian. Amphibians have smooth, moist skin and they breathe through lungs as added but through gills when young. Frog is the example of amphibian, which live both in water and on land. Turn the page. Third group, reptiles. Reptiles are vertebrates that have rough, scaly skin and breathe through lungs. Amphibian lungs. Lizard is the example of reptiles. Birds. Birds are animals that have a backbone and feather. Eagle is the example of bird. And the last one group, mammal. Mammals are animals that have fur, hair, or bristles on their skin.
they feed their babies on milk. Dear student, this is task for you to read daily one page from 1 to page number 12. But the animal kingdom, this is task for you to collect different invertebrates and vertebrates animals pictures and examples and paste on your copies.